Was that everything you hoped for?
Jury's still out. But man, can't deny that view.
Come on, this way. Hey, let's pick it up. Look, we're almost done. Stay focused.
Yes, ma'am.
Over the last few weeks, we've taken a look at and recapped the stories of some of The Last of Us's most important secondary characters as we gear up for the looming release of The Last of Us Part 2. And while it's hard to come to a conclusion about which secondary character in the game's excellent cast is the strongest, there's no question that one of the most memorable is Tess. As someone who is with Joel when his journey begins before he even meets Ellie, she certainly has a big presence in this story. And even though she doesn't make it, there's no doubt that even from beyond the grave, she will continue to have at least some impact on Joel and Ellie in The Last of Us Part 2. So here, we'll be focusing on Tess and recounting her whole story from start to finish. Like most of its other characters, The Last of Us doesn't hand out too much information about Tess's life before the cordyceps outbreak. When we meet her in the beginning of the game after the 20-year time skip, most of her backstory can only be gleaned through what the current events imply. We know that at some point she became a smuggler in the Boston quarantine zone, and that in doing so, she garnered a fierce reputation over the years. She and Joel have been partners in crime for a while by this time, with Joel acting as the muscle and Tess as the brains of the operation, which means she's also accumulated quite a few contacts. There's no question that Tess is a resourceful woman, and that even some of the most dangerous criminals in the QZ have come to respect her. Through her work, she's even come into contact to varying degrees with the likes of Bill and Marlene, the leader of the Fireflies. One person that Tess and Joel work with quite a lot is Robert, a man who operates as an illicit arms dealer in the quarantine zone, and it's a deal with him that sets things in motion when The Last of Us begins. The very first scene of the game after its prologue is over shows Tess arriving at Joel's apartment and informing him that while she was coming back from a deal, she got attacked by a couple of goons sent by Robert. Robert, as it turns out, owes Tess and Joel a cache of weapons of considerable worth, and his not wanting to or not being able to pay up is probably what led to his decision to take them both out. Tess isn't easily overwhelmed, though. She dealt with them without too many problems. While doing so, she also managed to find out where Robert is hiding. Armed with that information, Joel and Tess head out to the warehouse where he's hiding, intending to kill him and get the weapons that they're owed. They intend to make their way across a checkpoint in the QZ in order to get there, and though they almost make it through, they're forced to retreat and find another way around when the Fireflies bomb a military truck in the vicinity, leading to a fight breaking out and the checkpoint being closed. Eventually, they do make it to Robert's warehouse, and after sneaking and fighting their way past scores of men on his payroll, they catch up with him. He tries to make a break for it, but Tess breaks his leg with a metal pipe, proceeding to interrogate him about their weapons while Joel tortures him. And Robert fesses up, of course. He tells him that he sold the weapons he owed to the two of them to the Fireflies, moments before Tess shoots him in the head. Tess and Joel decide they're gonna have to make contact with the Fireflies in order to get their weapons back, but as luck would have it, the Fireflies end up making contact with them. Marlene, or Queen Firefly as Joel describes her, arrives on the scene moments after Robert's death. Tess demands their weapons back, but Marlene, after telling them that she paid for those weapons fair and square, offers them a deal instead. With the military wiping out the Fireflies left, right, and center, Marlene realizes that she needs help from a third party, so she tells Tess and Joel that if they smuggle something out of the city for her, she will pay them with twice as many weapons as what Robert owed them. That something is, of course, Ellie, and even though Joel is reluctant to take on the job, after Tess confirms that Marlene does indeed have the weapons she's promising to pay them with, she and Joel end up agreeing to the deal. Tess, Joel, and Ellie set out from the quarantine zone toward the Capitol building, which is where they're supposed to meet the group of Fireflies that will take Ellie off their hands. Things quickly go wrong, however, as they often do in The Last of Us. As the three of them are making their way through the QZ, they're attacked and caught by soldiers. After calling for backup, the soldiers do a routine scan for the cordyceps infection on each of them, but Ellie uses her switchblade to stab one of them in the leg. Using the distraction to their advantage, Joel and Tess manage to get the upper hand and kill both the soldiers. Something interesting catches Joel's eyes, though. He picks up the scanning device the soldiers had been using, which had been used on Ellie last. He sees a positive reading for the infection. Ellie explains to them that she was bit 3 weeks ago, and even though she's infected, she hasn't yet turned, even though everybody who contracts the infection turns within 2 days at most. Joel doesn't doesn't buy what she's saying, but Tess, who is more hopeful, convinces him to press on with their job and take Ellie to the Capitol building. Having made their way out of the QZ, the trio makes its way through the destroyed and desolate remains of Boston, having to go through scores of runners and clickers. There are many close calls, and some of them, as it turns out, are much more than that. But we'll get to that. After many trials and tribulations, Tess, Joel, and Ellie arrive at the Capitol building, but the Fireflies they were supposed to meet up with are not there. Well, they are there, but they're dead. Tess frantically searches their bodies, hoping to find a clue as to where they were headed, where they'd been intending to take Ellie, which Ellie herself doesn't know either. But Joel doesn't see the point. He tells Tess that they're wasting their time, that both he and Tess ordinarily wouldn't care about saving the world, wondering why they've pushed so far with this thing. It is at this point that Tess reveals that while they were making their way through the city, she got bitten and was infected in a scuffle with runners. Joel is devastated. But Tess, who knows she doesn't have much time, tells him that he has to press on. She asks him to take Ellie to his brother Tommy, who used to be a Firefly himself once, and as such might know where to take Ellie. Of course, Joel is reluctant to do so, but Tess insists, telling him that their close working and personal relationship over the years has to count for something, and that her asking him to do this has to mean something to him. Then things go from bad to worse, and soldiers from the QZ, who have been hunting down and killing the Fireflies, quickly descend upon the Capitol building. Tess, who refuses to let the infection take over her and turn her into one of the infected, tells Joel to take Ellie and go ahead, explaining that she'll stay behind and buy some time for the two of them. Joel, of course, initially tries to refuse, wanting to stay behind and fight with Tess, but Tess isn't having it. She shoves him away and tells him to take Ellie and get the hell out, and though he's reluctant to do so, that's exactly what he does. When the soldiers try getting in while Joel and Ellie are making their escape, Tess takes them on, and manages to kill two of them before getting shot and dying. Obviously, that is the last time we see Tess, but her presence can be felt throughout the entire game. If not for Tess, Joel wouldn't have been convinced to take Ellie out of Boston and trek across the entire country to get her through to the Fireflies. And though plenty of other things happen along the way that only reinforce his decision to do so, Tess's insistence that he take Ellie to Tommy is what kickstarts his journey. It's unlikely that we'll ever see Tess again, but given how much of an impact she's had on Ellie and especially Joel, it goes without saying that she'll continue to be an important part of the story, even if not to a great extent. We'll find out soon enough, because The Last of Us Part 2 is not far away. And that about does it for this video. If you enjoyed what you watched and want to see more from GamingBolt, please hit the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to switch on the notifications bell icon next to it. That way you'll never miss any of our videos. Thanks for watching!